गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आज हम मेलिन ट्रांसफॉर्म और कुछ स्टैंडर्ड फंक्शंस के मेलिन ट्रांसफॉर्म किस तरह से फाइंड आउट किए जा सकते हैं उसके बारे में अपन स्टडी करें। तो अपन ये जानते हैं कि किसी भी फंक्शन एफ एक्स यदि कोई फंक्शन है तो उस फंक्शन का यदि मेलिन ट्रांसफॉर्म अपन को निकालना है तो मेलिन ट्रांसफॉर्म अपन जानते हैं यदि उसको fp से डिनोट करें, the Mellin transform of the function fx is denoted by fp, then this is equals to integral 0 to infinity x raised to p minus 1 fx dx. Now, we will prove some problems with the help of the definition of the Mellin transform. The problem first is we have to find the Mellin transform of the function e raised to minus ax. So, Mellin transform of the function e raised to minus ax, by the definition, this is equals to integral 0 to infinity x raised to p minus 1 e raised to minus ax dx. Or this can be written as integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus ax x raised to p minus 1 dx. Now, if you recall the Laplace transform, the Laplace transform, we see that the Laplace transform of a function fx is integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus px fx dx. So, comparing with the Laplace transform, we see that this is the Laplace transform of the function x raised to p minus 1. So, this is the Laplace transform of the function x raised to p minus 1. And we know that the Laplace transform of the function x raised to p minus 1 is gamma p upon p raised to n. So, by this one, if we compare Laplace transform, then this is the Laplace transform of x raised to p minus 1 with parameter a, or we can write the Laplace transform of this function, then this is gamma p upon a raised to p. So we find that the Mellin transform of the function e raised to minus ax is gamma p upon a raised to p. This is the first problem. Now, the second problem, we have to find the Laplace transform of the function sin x and cos x. We are going to find the Laplace transform of the function sin x and cos x. Now we use the definition of the gamma function. We see that the integral 0 to infinity x raised to p minus 1 e raised to minus iota dx is gamma p upon iota raised to p. This is the definition of the gamma function. Or this can be written as gamma p into iota raised to minus p. If we write iota raised to minus p as cos pi by 2 plus iota sin pi by 2, then this is equals to gamma p into cos pi by 2 plus iota sin pi by 2 whole raised to minus p. If we take minus p inside, then we get this one as gamma p cos p pi by 2 minus iota sin p pi by 2. Or in the left hand side, if we write e raised to minus iota x in the form of sine and cosine x, then this is equals to integral 0 to infinity x raised to p minus 1 cos x minus iota sin x dx is equals to gamma p into cos p pi by 2 minus iota sin p pi by 2. Now comparing both the sides, the left hand side and the right hand side, the real part and the imaginary part. If we compare the real part, then we get integral 0 to infinity x raised to p minus 1 cos x dx, and on the right hand side, this real part is gamma p into cos p pi by 2. And as we know that integral 0 to infinity x raised to p minus 1 cos x dx is the Mellin transform of the function cos x. So, the Mellin transform of the function cos x with respect to parameter p is nothing but it is equals to gamma p into cos p pi by 2. Similarly, if we compare the imaginary part, then we get left hand side, on the left hand side, integral 0 to infinity x raised to p minus 1 sin x dx, and on the right hand side this is equals to gamma p into sin p pi by 2. And we see that in the left hand side 0 to infinity integral x raised to p minus 1 sin x dx is the Mellin transform of the function sin x. So the Mellin transform of the sin function sin px sin x with respect to parameter p is gamma p into sin p pi by 2. So we can get the Mellin transform of the function sin x and cos x with the help of the gamma functions. Another problem we can solve here. We We have to prove that the Mellin transform of 1 plus x raised to minus a. We have to find the Mellin transform of the function 1 plus x raised to minus a with respect to parameter p, and then we have to prove that this is equal to gamma p into gamma a minus p upon gamma op. Here we use the definition of the beta function as the beta function, which is in the form of gamma function, is equal to gamma of n upon gamma of 1 plus n, m plus n. This is equal to x raised to n minus 1 upon 1 plus x raised to m plus n. Now if you put it, m plus n is equal to a, that is m is equal to a minus n, then we get the left hand integral 0 to infinite x raised to n minus 1 upon 1 plus x raised to a dx. And on the right hand side, this is equal to gamma of a minus n, gamma of n upon gamma of a. Or this can be written as integral 0 to infinite x raised to n minus 1, 1 plus x raised to minus a dx. And this is equal to gamma of a minus n, gamma of n upon gamma of a. Now if you replace n by p, then we see that this is equal to integral 0 to infinite x raised to p minus 1, 1 plus x raised to minus a dx is equal to gamma of a minus p, gamma of p upon gamma of a. And if we compare the left hand side with the definition of the Mellin transform, we see that this is the Mellin transform of the function 1 plus x raised to minus a. So we get the Mellin transform of the function 1 plus x raised to minus a with respect to parameter p. This is equal to gamma of p, gamma of a minus p upon gamma of a, which is the required problem. So with the help of the gamma functions and beta function, we can find some Mellin transform of some important functions. Thank you. Thank you very much.